So hello everybody, this is my second class of child psychiatry lecture series. The topic today I have picked up is disruptive mood dysregulation disorder. It is a very very specific topic of child psychiatry. This child psychiatry lecture series has comprising of 10 lectures. The second I have picked up is disruptive mood dysregulation disorder. Now as far as this lecture is concerned, it is a teaching lecture for psychiatry PG student, not for a consultant. Okay, it is for the beginners. It just contains the basic information for understanding and writing answers in the exam. Okay, the purpose of this lecture, and to take home some handwritten notes for ready reference for clinical practice and clinical stuff. Okay, so let us start. The topic I have picked up is disruptive mood dysregulation disorder. It is a short topic of exam, but important. Let's start. First point is, it is a new disorder in DSM-5. Now the clinical features. You need to remember that the onset of this disorder, age group is 6 to 18 years. Okay. The age group, mostly the onset will happen before 10 years of age, but age group is 6 to 18 years. Symptom duration must be at least above 12 months, at least 1 year of symptoms. Now, what are the key symptoms? The key symptoms are, number one, temper outburst, anger outburst, amounting to verbal as well as physical aggression. Now these temper outbursts are out of proportion to the situation. Now this is something you need to understand. To be angry in a particular situation to a particular extent, suppose somebody abuses you or hates you, and it's okay to be angry, and that anger is explainable by that particular situation. But suppose somebody just said something to you and you are about to blow his head. So out of proportion to the situation, that is the key word. Okay, anger out of proportion to the developmental level of the child. Since it is a child issue, so sometimes the children are too much angry as compared to their developmental level. Anger episodes at least 3 times per week. Okay, and the fifth and the most important point, I would like to highlight it in red color. In between mood is irritable most of the times. So the boy or the girl or the child will have anger outburst, but in between mood is going to be irritable. This is my own understanding of DMDD, which I am extrapolating. DMDD will have an anger episode, again an anger episode, again an anger episode. Okay, but he never touches the baseline. In between the two anger episodes, the mood remains irritable. Okay, this is the anger outburst. This is DMDD. Point number E is, symptom must be present in two situations. I think you have read something similar to this in ADHD, where symptom must be present in two situations: school, home, outside, etc., etc. Okay, symptom must not meet diagnostic criteria of mania or hypomania for more than one day. Now this is some point you need to understand. Have a look towards me. This expansile mood, irritable mood, anger outburst can be explainable by a mood disorder per se, mania or hypomania. So elevated mood can cause these type of symptoms, but for mania or hypomania, the duration has to be hypomania 4 days and mania 7 days. These symptoms match mania and hypomania for just one day. After that, they don't match. So we cannot label them as mania and hypomania. So clinically, they look similar, but those symptoms must not be more than for one day, similar to those of mania and hypomania. Next, this anger must not be explainable by any other primary psychiatric disorder. Sometimes anger outbursts are present in the patients of autism, in major depressive disorder, so it must not be explainable. Next, last point is symptom must not be caused or must not be attributable to a substance or explainable by a medical or neurological condition. Now, DMDD has been a controversial diagnosis because it looks like a variant of a mood disorder itself. But what the longitudinal studies have shown in DMDD that these patients may progress to a full-blown bipolar disorder or anxiety disorder or depression. But to my surprise or to your attention, they are more likely to go here as compared to here. This is given in Kaplan psychiatry textbook. This can be an MCQ, that DMDD is more likely to progress in longitudinal study to anxiety disorder. DMDD comorbidities can be an MCQ. Suppose they ask you, what is the most common comorbidity of DMDD? Then the answer has to be ADHD, ODD, anxiety disorder, and depression. Okay, the most common is ADHD in this sequence. Okay, up to 80% people, patient with DMDD have this. Approximately 47% have this, approximately 20% have this. So ADHD is the most common comorbidity. Now, regarding the differential diagnosis of DMDD, the first one is bipolar itself. But there's a very distinctive feature to differentiate DMDD from bipolar. If you know the curve of bipolar is known for its episodicity and intervening period normal. And this is your DMDD. So it is a chronic disorder and it is an episodic disorder. Moreover, bipolar can have psychotic symptom on and off. Mania with psychosis, depression with psychosis, and DMDD psychotic symptoms are mostly absent. Mostly. The second major differential diagnosis, as you might have noticed, is oppositional defiant disorder. Oppositional defiant is problem mainly against authority figures. So how do you differentiate it from DMDD? The key feature here is annoyance and defiance. And this is not so in DMDD. The third differential diagnosis to be kept in mind is IED. I hope some of you might be knowing about IED as well. intermittent explosive disorder. Once again, not very difficult to differentiate IED and DMDD, that IED have temper outburst, normal, and DMDD have temper outburst, normal, but in between irritable. So IED again is a purely episodic anger outburst. There are few other differential diagnoses like ADHD itself, then your conduct disorder, then your major depressive disorder, and substance use disorder. As far as management is concerned, we do not know the exact pathophysiology of DMDD so far. So management will depend on symptomatically if the symptoms are similar to that of depression plus your ADHD. Then the management says that it is managed by your SSRI plus stimulants. But if the symptoms are phenotypically similar to those of bipolar disorder, then the management is like that of our bipolar disorder, atypical antipsychotics along with mood stabilizers. This is all you need to know about a very, very short and small topic, DMDD. Okay, it is expected as a 10 mark question in the exam, or sometime 5 mark, and if you write this much stuff, it is more than sufficient. And you must keep this picture in your mind. This is drawn by myself whenever you think of DMDD, that anger outburst, in between irritable mood, anger outburst. And regarding diagnostic criteria, 3 times per week, duration more than 12 months, never diagnose it beyond 18, onset has to be before 10. So this is the topic of the day, disruptive mood dysregulation disorder. Thank you very much. Hope to hear back from you.